from the St. Ignatius Chapel at the Manresa Jesuit Spiritual Renewal Center in Pickering, Ontario. The National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from an anonymous donor from Calgary, Alberta. This Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of her husband who passed away on October 26, 2008. Prayers for her living and deceased family members, for physical healing, improved health, for the return of her family members to the Church and to their faith, for world peace, and in thanksgiving for the Daily TV Mass. On behalf of all who are gathered here for this sacred celebration, we thank our donor for the gift of this Mass. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves on this Lady Saturday before the Lord, just like Mary placed herself before God 2,000 years ago, knowing that she was weak, knowing that all goodness came from God. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who chose the Blessed Virgin Mary, foremost among the poor and humble, to be the mother of the Savior, grant, we pray, that following her example, we may offer you the homage of sincere faith and place in you all our hope of salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Each of us was given grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore, it is said, when he ascended on high, he made captivity itself a captive. He gave gifts to his people. When it says he ascended, what does it mean? But that he had also descended into the lower parts of the earth? He who descended is the same one who ascended far above all the heavens, so that he might fill all things. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ until all of us come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to maturity, to the measure of the full stature of Christ. We must no longer be children, tossed to and fro and blown about by every wind of doctrine, by people's trickery, by their craftiness and deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ, from whom the whole body, joined and knit together by every ligament with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promotes the body's growth in building itself up in love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us go rejoicing to the to the house of us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. As was decreed for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. For there the thrones for judgment were set up. Go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus was teaching the crowds, some of those present told him about the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. Jesus asked them, "Do you think that because these Galileans suffered in this way, they were worse sinners than all other Galileans? No, I tell you, but unless you repent, you will all perish as they did. Or those 18 who were killed when the Tower of Siloam fell on them, do you think that they were worse offenders than all the other living in Jerusalem? No, I tell you, but unless you repent, you will all perish as they did." Then Jesus told this parable. A man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came looking for fruit on it and found none. So he said to the gardener, "See here, for 3 years I have come to look for fruit on this fig tree, and still I find none. Cut it down. Why should it be wasting the soil?" The gardener replied, "Sir, let it alone for one more year until I dig around it and put manure on it. If it bears fruit, next year, well and good, but if not, you can cut it down." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's a whole lot of stuff here in these readings, and especially in the Gospel reading, it addresses right at the beginning, it addresses why stuff happens to people, why bad things happen to people. And of course, it's a mystery. Now, of course, usually when something happens, people might say, yeah, because the person was smoking or he drove reckless or whatever, and we can find a reason. But most of what happens, we don't have reasons. Why does someone have to get cancer? Why does someone crossing the road is being killed by a car or whatever? So it's mystery. And Jesus addresses that there are no worse sinners or no worse off than other people. It just happens. But in that, and then the next part, of course, with the thing about the fig tree, it really talks about God's infinite mercy, the infinite patience God has to wait for each one of us to flourish in our vocation, to flourish in our vocation. And in the first reading of Ephesians, St. Paul talks about that too, to we all have been given different gifts. God has given each one of us unique gifts to be used for the kingdom. And just like Mary received, as the Mother of God received a certain gift. But that gift also changes over time. We often forget that our vocation or calling from God changes over time. For instance, Mary, the Mother of God, her vocation changed several times in her life. First of all, as a child, her vocation was to learn and to be a good child and to be obedient. She became a mother, the vocation of a mother, which is so important, which is that total giving of self for the next generation. Mary knew the vocation of being a widow, having to do it all by yourself and no support of your husband. And so many people know about that too in our days. And of course, as we know by tradition, that she spent her last 30 years or so of her life in Ephesus praying. The vocation of praying. We often forget how that is a vocation. And especially when we get older and our bodies start to break down and we cannot move around, we cannot run here and there. But to be praying for the church, to be praying for world peace, to be praying for migrants and those who are suffering in our society, those who are, say, abused in marriages and so on. But our vocation changes as we go along our life journey. But it's for us to discover that vocation, to discover the vocation. The vocation of a widow without children can be different than the vocation of a widow with grandchildren. Different vocation, but still a calling from God. And so we have to discover our own vocation as we go along life. And today, actually, on the universal calendar, please forgive me if I don't pronounce the name right, but Jose, Blessed Jose Gregorio Hernandez Cisneros died in 1990. He, 1919, and he is a beautiful example of discovering a vocation. He was extremely intelligent. He's Venezuelan. He studied in Caracas, Paris, and Berlin. And so he was a very gifted medical doctor. But he had this great desire to enter religious life, to the Franciscans or even to the Carthusians. But every time he tried, he started studying in Rome, actually theology. Every time he tried, he got sick. He just got sick. And twice he really tried to enter a religious order, but when he tried, he just was so sick that he could not enter. And he said, oh, okay, so I understand where God wants me. So I have to be that medical doctor. I cannot be a gifted medical doctor and sit somewhere in a cloister and pray. So he was very well known as a medical doctor in Caracas, Venezuela, but he was very much looking after those who had so much less, the poor, and so on. And actually, eventually, in 1919, he was killed crossing the road with medication for a person who was very poor. But discovering our own vocation as we go along our life. And some of you know a little bit about my own life story, how that has evolved, my changing vocation. And my vocation will continue to change as I get older, and especially when I start to look forward as I speak to it about it. As my own health breaks down, and that I probably will be spending some time in a nursing home, to waiting for God to bring me home, but to pray for the world, to pray for all those who need so many prayers. And the world needs so many prayers. And of course, as our vocation changes, also to learn as we grow with God, to become patient, like patient with other people, like God, not to have big expectations of people around us, to be there and to just love them for where they are, and to be patient, so they can also grow in their own vocations. Amen. So let us bring our prayers before the Lord. Please stand. We pray for all those in our daily TV Mass prayer intention book. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In this month dedicated to Mary, we join in the community prayer of the Church through the mysteries of the Rosary. May we come to walk with Jesus on his earthly pilgrimage as we say, Hail, Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With Pope Francis, we pray this month that the Church continue to sustain in all ways a synodal lifestyle as a sign of co-responsibility, promoting the participation of the communion and the mission shared among priests, religious, and lay people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And with Our Lady, Mother of God, we pray for the return to the faith of loved ones who have abandoned our Catholic faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, the offerings of our devotion, and grant that we, who celebrate your Son's work of boundless charity, may through the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary be confirmed in love of you and of our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalt praise as we acclaim.
Blessed.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, the order bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
And may the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I passionately desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my soul, so that I may unite myself wholly to you, now and forever. Amen.
And let us pray. Grant to your church, O Lord, that strengthened by the power of this sacrament, she may eagerly walk in the pathways of the gospel until she reaches the blessed vision of peace, which the Virgin Mary, your lowly handmaid, already enjoys eternally in glory. Through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donor for the gift of this Mass.